Thank you for watching this video from KingswaySoft. Today, I will be introducing the IBM MQ components from within the SSIS Productivity Pack product. The SSIS Productivity Pack is a collection of premium SSIS components which enable greater developer productivity and increases the power of SSIS. Using our IBM MQ components, we can facilitate integration with IBM MQ and WebSphere MQ from within SSIS. As of this recording, the SSIS Productivity Pack offers three IBM MQ components: IBM MQ Connection Manager, IBM MQ Source, and IBM MQ Destination. The Connection Manager can be used to establish connections with IBM MQ and WebSphere MQ. The source components can be used to read or retrieve messages from IBM MQ and WebSphere MQ, whereas the destination component can be used to send messages to an IBM MQ and WebSphere MQ. Let's begin by creating our IBM MQ Connection Manager. Right-click on the Connection Manager area down below to add a new connection. Select the IBM MQ item to add this new connection manager. The queue manager name field is the name of the queue manager that the component will connect to. If the queue manager is not on the local machine, it can be accessed remotely. Once this option is enabled, the next field will be available for the remote machine. Channel name is a channel on the local machine that will be used to connect to the remote machine. This defaults to the system channel, as you can see here. You may change to a different one as needed. You would then enter your user ID and password to connect to the queue. In our example today, we will be connecting to a queue manager on our local machine. Before we hit OK, we should test the connection to make sure our information is correct and we can connect successfully. Please note that the connection manager that we just created is a package-level connection manager. For SSIS 2012 or later, you can create project-level connection managers if you right-click the Connection Managers node within the Solution Explorer. Let's begin configuring a data flow task, starting with our IBM MQ source component by dragging it to the design surface. Double-click to open its editor form. As mentioned before, the IBM MQ source component is an SSIS data flow pipeline component that can be used to read and receive data from IBM MQ and WebSphere MQ. Let's select an IBM MQ Connection Manager. There are two types of entities available to connect to: queue and topic. When the topic option is selected, a list of associated topics will be in the dropdown. There is also an option to enable system topics. When the queue option is selected, a list of available queues will be presented. There are two different modes available for receiving messages: peek and receive and delete. If the peek option is selected, messages will be received from the queue without deleting them or modifying the queue in any way. If the receive messages and delete option is selected, messages will be retrieved and deleted from the queue. It is only possible to select a listener mode if the receive mode is receive and delete. After the IBM MQ component has retrieved all available messages from the queue, it can continue to listen for more messages for a period of time. There are three listener modes available. Listener modes other than none are only compatible with the receive and delete receive mode. The fixed time mode allows the component to listen for messages for a specified period of time. The wait until mode allows the component to listen for messages until a specified date and time. The wait until variable mode allows the component to listen for messages until a date and time specified in a variable. For today's demo, we will select peek as our receive mode. Navigating to the columns page, this will show a default list of properties of messages that will be retrieved. Clicking the Refresh Component button causes the component to retrieve the latest metadata and update each field to its most recent metadata. Let's click OK to finish configuring our source component. For this demonstration, we're going to add a dummy data reader destination component for the purpose of showing you how the data flows from the source to destination components. We can now execute this task. We will now demonstrate sending messages using the IBM MQ Destination Component. Let's begin by generating some sample data using our Data Spawner component, which is also a part of our Productivity Pack offering. Drag the IBM MQ Destination Component from the SSIS Toolbox to the Design Surface and connect the two. We'll first need to select an IBM MQ Connection Manager. There are two entity types available, Queue and Topic. If the topic option is selected, a list of available topics will be presented. There is also an option to show system topics. After selecting a topic, you can enter a topic string to be used to route the messages sent to that topic. When the queue option is selected, a list of available queues will be presented. You can also choose to show system queues. Heading to the columns page, we can map columns from upstream components to destination attributes. The last page is the error handling page, where there are three error handling mechanisms to choose from. The default option is fail on error, where the entire data flow task will fail as soon as an error occurs. There is also the redirect rows to error output, where the error output will contain the failed records with extra columns, error code, error column, and error message. There is also a third option, which is to ignore any errors that may have occurred. Let's click OK to finish configuring our destination component. We can now execute this task. This concludes a demonstration of the IBM MQ components within our SSIS Productivity Pack. There are many other components in the SSIS Productivity Pack that enable developers to accomplish more in SSIS in a much more productive fashion. IBM MQ and WebSphere MQ is just one of the messaging queue technologies that are supported. The Productivity Pack comes with a few other messaging queue support, including Azure Service Bus, MSMQ, RabbitMQ, and so on. Please feel free to take a look at our other videos available for viewing on our website or YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video. For any additional questions, please feel free to reach out to us.